In the previous video, we saw about changes following mild orthodontic forces. In this video, we will continue with the changes following excessive orthodontic forces. So, what kind of changes can we expect when the force is more than normal? We may think more force, more tooth movement. No, it is wrong. The more you give force, more adverse reactions are expected from the living tissue that is surrounding the tooth. As we saw already, excessive force or normal force, we always have the pressure side and tension side. In case of excessive force, the pressure side sees the following changes. The periodontal ligament is crushed due to the more than optimal force, and occlusion of the blood vessels may result in lack of nutrition to the blood to the periodontal ligament surrounding the tooth, which may result in more regressive changes and death of the tissue. The PDL ligament is deprived of the nutritional supply which it needs for its survival or vitality. Regressive changes seen in the periodontal ligament leads to the histological tissue known as hyalinization, hyalinized tissue. The process of hyalinization leads to lack of bone resorption, which needs to be there for the tooth to move in the socket. Due to ischemia and hyalinization, no osteoclast recruitment happens, which normally happens in the ideal orthoforce. So no osteoclast recruitment means no resorption. Therefore, initially the tooth does not move in spite of the excessive orthodontic force it is undergoing. So tooth does not move initially, which leads to the lag period. This lag period stays for prolonged time than normal, and after that bone resorption occurs, but not in the hyalinized zone, which is adjacent to the PDL, but it occurs under the hyalinized zone. Under the hyalinized zone of the PDL. Therefore, this type of resorption is called undermining resorption or backward resorption, rearward resorption. Whereas in the minimal force, mild force, we saw the resorption is known as frontal resorption or direct resorption. Here, under the hyalinized zone, the resorption happens. In excessive orthoforce, we see undermining resorption or rearward resorption. So, what are the features of this undermining resorption? It does not happen in the socket wall adjacent to the PDL. That is no periosteal bone resorption. But it occurs in the bone marrow space, which is behind the PDL, which is behind the periosteum. That is the endosteal spaces, which is not needed here. Actually, it is usually of detrimental in nature to the tooth and the periodontal ligament. It is not desirable also. This type of resorption is seen in where we employ excessive orthodontic force. Therefore, please remember that more the orthoforce, it doesn't mean the tooth moves more. It also means that the tissues are undergoing more damage. So therefore, after lag period, the under the hyalinized zone, that is under the regressive zone, we see some kind of bone loss, and it is not desirable. It usually makes the tooth loose in the socket. So we saw the main changes in the pressure side. What happens if the force is more than excessive? Apart from the PDL being damaged, the tooth also undergoes some kind of damage. The tooth surface may show resorption. It may undergo ankylosis or lose its vitality. The tooth becomes a dead tooth or may become in the process of becoming a dead tooth. It eventually causes the patient more discomfort and pain, which is not normally a feature of ortho treatment. So in the tension side, that is the side opposing the direction of the ortho force, the PDL ligament are overstretched, which eventually leads to the tearing of the blood vessels present in the PDL ligament. This tearing of blood vessels eventually means ischemia and loss of blood supply. The ischemia means prevention of nutrition to the surrounding PDL ligament, and therefore less osteoblast activity. In mild orthoforce, there was bone formation, but here, due to the less osteoblast activity and almost nil activity, the tooth may become loose in the socket. So, what will be the ideal orthodontic force? Or the optimal orthodontic force. First of all, what are the features of the ideal force? There should be rapid movement with less patient discomfort and less damage. That is what we desire from an ortho treatment. So, what amount of force need to be employed? The optimum force advised by Oppenheim and Schwarz suggests the value of 20 to 26 gram per centimeter square of root surface. This value was in approximately correlated with the capillary pulse pressure. Therefore, the blood vessels do not get occluded or do not get teared upon. This 20 to 26 grams per centimeter square of root surface is considered more or less the ideal or the optimal orthodontic force. Histologically, we can also confirm it by the forward resorption or frontal resorption which is present, no undermining or rearward resorption, and vitality of the tooth and the PDL ligament are maintained. Similarly, the integrity of the periodontal ligament is also maintained. There is no tearing or crushing of the periodontal ligament. Hope you understand the concept behind the movement of a tooth in ideal and excessive orthodontic force. A handwritten copy of these notes are available in our blog. Please do visit our blog.